Hey kids, today we're making beef broccoli.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
First, I am going to brown my sliced beef. This is a little over a pound. And I was asked what kind of beef it was, and I couldn't truthfully say because it comes cut up like this, and I never pay attention, but it's beef rounds. Joni asked me that, Joan3424. So I'm going to brown this. I'm going to add in, that was olive oil in there. I'm actually going to add in some of these chopped garlic. It's dried, so when we add in the liquid, it will be all good. So let me get this a little bit more cooked, and I'm going to add in a tablespoon of flour. So let me be back. I'm going to add in that tablespoon of flour now, and that's just gonna coat the beef, but it's also going to become a thickening agent once we start adding in the liquids. I'm gonna add in, I'm sharing the measuring cup here with 2 tablespoons of shoyu or soy sauce, as well as 2 tablespoons of sherry wine. And then this is 2 teaspoons of sugar, and it's supposed to be 1 tablespoon of grated ginger, but you know how I like to use my ginger powder. It's so much easier, faster. So I put about a little under 1/2 tablespoon of that, since it is a little bit more concentrated in that powder form. So we're gonna just go ahead and cook this for just the tiniest bit. And then I'm going to add in a bunch of other things that I don't really have measured. It calls for 2 pounds of broccoli, but I'm putting in what I know we will eat and not waste anymore. I bought that at the farmer's market there. And this is about 1 teaspoon of salt. I will probably put some pepper in there. Here's a cup of water. And we're going to add in the lovely oyster sauce. And I know several people have asked for, this is about 2 tablespoons we're gonna add, okay? Several people have asked, what can we put in instead of oyster sauce? Google it, because someone once told me a while ago, because people have asked that in the past. I don't remember the answer. I love oyster sauce. We have it readily available to us. And so I don't know what else to use. Anyway, we're just gonna cook this for 1 or 2 minutes. The broccoli can stay still crunchy, which is always very nice. Or you can cook it a little bit, a little further, but your meat might get a little tough if you continue to cook it for very long. So I think I'm gonna hit it with some pepper, and I'm just gonna let it cook for a little bit until this starts to thicken up a little from that flour we threw in earlier, and call it beef broccoli. I know I don't know that I explained it, but I always constantly make meals when I run across the different version of something that I've already made. I always like to try it. I'm always searching for that one dish that, it's like, okay, I don't have to look any further because I found the one that I want. So the other one that I put up was good, but you can always find one that you go, ho. Just like I think my oyster sauce chicken, I'd done one before, and then I did that one that's called Uncle Dan's Oyster Sauce Chicken, and that was the winner. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, please give me a thumbs up. Share the video, that way I get seen by others. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe. Leave me a comment, and we'll see you the next time in the kitchen. Aloha. That's delicious, folks. I don't think I'm gonna look any further. Enjoy.
to say goodbye. Make sure you comment and subscribe, and it would be so good.